Something that's always bugged me with Jira is that Atlassian make it so difficult to extract data for cycle time natively. Now, I know this bothers a lot of you too from all the discussions we've had on it. Now, if you'd like to have this in Jira, your cycle time, start and end dates, and the actual cycle time calculated, and be able to extract the data easily, then watch on, as that's exactly what you can do, free, natively, and no apps needed. I've done a number of videos on how to do this already using Atlassian Marketplace plugins, such as Time in Status or EazyBI, links in the description below. But they require you to buy and install plugins, and if you've got a lot of users, it can get very expensive. And in some cases, your organization won't install them due to security or governance issues, even if they're happy to spend the money. So I've always been on the lookout for a free, native, and importantly, easy way of doing this. And thanks to John Prowse, hopefully I pronounced that correctly, apologies if not, I've now found a way. So big shout out to you, John. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through all the steps needed. Let's get into it. Now, I'm really excited about this method because it's going to open up flow metrics for many people that weren't in a position to buy external plugins for Jira. Now, I still maintain, though, that using Atlassian Marketplace plugins, EasyBI or Time in Status is the easiest method. And it also provides you with a lot more functionality, but it is not going to work for everyone. And you can also do it via the API, but it's not quite as easy, it's a bit trickier. Now, with the method I'm going to explain, you only need to create three custom fields, update a screen, and use some of Jira's automation. Now, you'll need admin rights, though, to the Jira project you're working on. This isn't always possible, so you'll either have to work closely with a Jira admin or write some detailed instructions for them. Either way, it's easy, so let's get into it. So the first thing you're going to need to do is create three custom fields for the Jira project you're working in. Now, these three fields are going to store firstly the date for when your story enters in progress, which in our example here is the start of our cycle time. And secondly, they're going to store the date when our story enters done, which in our example here is the end of our cycle time. And thirdly, they're going to store the actual cycle time of our story, which is the difference between the two dates plus one day. Now, this plus one day is so that we capture every part of the day. And in addition, if we didn't do that, if a story completed inside one day, then our cycle time would be zero, which is not helpful. Now, if you're lucky enough to have admin rights, then go to the settings cog, click it, and select issues. Then, on the left-hand side, select custom fields and click on that. Then click Create Custom Field. A Select Field Type box will pop up. The type of field you want to select is Date Picker, so click on that and click Next. Now type a name for your new custom field. I chose CT Start as it's going to be my cycle time start date. And you can put something in the description if you like, but I left it blank. Then click Create. You'll then be presented with a screen asking you to associate your new custom field to screens. Only select the default screen and then click Update. Now repeat this process for your second custom date field, but this time change the name. I called mine CT End as it's the end date for my cycle time. Now create your third custom field. Click Create Custom Field. A Select Field Type box will pop up. And this time, the type of field you want to select is Number Field. So click on that and click Next. Now, name your custom field. I called mine Cycle Time. You can put something in the description if you like, but I just left mine blank. And click Create. You'll then be presented with a screen asking you to associate your new custom field to screens. Only select Default Screen and then click Update. These three new fields are going to hold the date for your cycle times and the actual cycle time itself, but we need a way to populate them. Before we do that, we need to make some screen updates. Now, by default, all of the custom fields we've created will be editable manually. Now, this is obviously no good because people could just go in and make favorable changes, shall we say. So, we're going to have to fix that by making these new custom fields non-editable. Now first, we need to make a copy of your project screen. Now if you click the settings cog and then projects, select the project you're interested in, and then click screens, you can see the main screen that your project uses. You can see here that mine is SS Scrum default issue screen. So now click the settings cog and then issues, then select screens. Select the screen you want to copy. Here, you can see that I need to make a copy of SS Scrum default issue screen, as that's the main screen associated with my project. So click the three dots and click copy. It will ask you for a name, and my suggestion is to use the same name, but put view in front of it, and then click copy. So you'll see your new screen here. Now, click the three dots by your new screen and click configure. Now here, you'll see a list of all the issues displayed on the screen. And make sure that you have cycle time, CT end, and CT start by using the select field drop-down at the bottom. Now changes are saved immediately, so there's no save button. Now click Screens on the left-hand side to return us to the screen page. On our original screen, SS Scrum Default Issue Screen, click the three dots and click Configure. This time, remove our three new custom fields, Cycle Time, CT Start, and CT End, and as before, it saves immediately, so there is no Save button. Now, go to Screen Schemes. We need to add a new scheme, so click Add Screen Scheme. My suggestion is to use the same name as our newly created screen, so name it View SS Scrum Default Issue Screen, and then select the screen to associate it to. So click the Default Screen drop-down box and select View SS Scrum Default Issue Screen, and then click Add. Now click on Issue Type Screen Schemes, and then click on Add Issue Type Screen Scheme. Type the name of your newly created screen, so View SS Scrum Default Issue Screen, and then select that screen from the drop-down box and click Add. Now we need to make a screen change to our project, so select the Settings cog and select Projects. Now click the three dots next to the project you want to amend, and then click Project Settings. Now click on Screens. Now click on the arrow here to expand your default screen. You can see here that you can associate various screens to each type of operation. Now we want to change the View Issue screen to our newly created screen, so click on the pencil icon to edit. Now click on Associate an Issue Operation with a Screen. Now under Issue Operation drop-down box, select View Issue, and then select our new screen, View SS Scrum Default Issue Screen, and then click Add. Okay, that is it. This will stop our new custom fields from being edited, so no one can make any naughty manual updates. Our three new custom fields, Cycle Time, CT Start, and CT End, will only be visible once they've been populated by the Jira observation. Because they don't contain any default values, you only see CT Start once a story enters in progress, and you'll only see CT End and Cycle Time once the story enters done. Right, it's now time to get our custom fields populated, and to do this, we're going to use Jira automation. So, as before, if you're lucky enough to have Jira admin rights to your project, click on the Settings cog. If not, you'll either have to do this with a Jira admin or take down some detailed notes. After clicking on the Settings cog, click Projects. You'll then see a list of projects displayed. Now for the project you're interested in, click on the three dots next to that project and click Project Settings. As you can see here, for me, it was the SBA Squad project. And then on the left-hand side, click on Automation. Now here, you're going to create two rules. The first will be to add the date that your story first enters the in-progress status to your custom field CT Start. So why the first time? Well, because as I'm sure you know, the story can go up and down our workflow on occasion. But we want to capture the very first time it entered in progress, the first time it was actually started, in order to capture the real cycle time. Now, the second rule you'll create is to add the date that your story last enters the done status to your custom field CT End, as well as calculating the actual cycle time and populating that to the cycle time custom field. Okay, so why the last time it enters the done status? Well, for the same reason. A story can go up and down a workflow even after it's entered done, and we want to capture the true cycle time. Right, so let's create our first rule. Click on Create Rule. You'll be presented with the Rule Builder screen. Now here, you're going to be able to apply rules in the when, if, then style. So we're going to add a trigger. Click on Issue Triggers under Add a Trigger, and then select Issue Transitioned. You'll see the Issue Transition box appear. Now this is where you can select which transition you're moving to. Now it depends on your workflow. You could select something like to do in the from status box and in progress in the to status box. In my example, I'm only interested in when a story transitions to in progress regardless of where they've transitioned from. So I'm only going to select in progress in the to status box, then select next. Now we want to select an optional if condition here. Because we only want to populate our CT Start custom field if it's never previously been populated, so click if add a condition. You'll see the Add a Condition box appear. Here, select Issue Fields Condition. Now, the field we want to select is the CT Start custom field we created. And the condition we're going to select is empty, because we only want the date entered into this field if the story has never previously passed through the in-progress status. Then click on Next. And finally, we're going to add a Then action. So click Then Add an Action. Under Add an Action, select Issue Actions, then select Edit Issue. In the Choose Fields to Set drop-down, select our custom field CT Start. And once selected, you'll see a box labeled CT Start. Now in this box, type curly bracket, now, end curly bracket. And this is a Jira Smart value that will put the current date into our custom field. Now click on More Options and deselect Send Notifications, as we don't want this rule to send any. Then select Next and name your rule. If a Name Your Rule box doesn't appear after clicking Next, just click Turn On Rule. I just called mine Cycle Time Start. and allow all admins to edit. And very importantly, don't forget to click turn on rule as the final step. The rule is now saved. Okay, now for our last rule. So click create rule again. As before, you'll be presented with the trigger screen. Click on issue triggers under add a trigger and then select issue transitioned. You'll see the issue transition box appear. This is where you can select the transition that you're moving to. Right here, you're going to select when your story transitions to done. As before, it does depend on your workflow, but I'm only interested in when a story transitions to done, regardless of where it's transitioned from. So I'm only going to select done in the to status. Then select next. Now we're going to select a then condition. So click then add an action. Under add an action, select issue actions and then select edit issue. In the choose fields to set dropdown, select our custom field CT end. Now once selected, you'll see a box labeled CT end. In this box, type curly bracket, now, end curly bracket. And this is the Jira smart value that will put the current date into our custom field. Now click on more options and deselect send notifications as we don't want this rule to send any. Then select next. Now we're gonna select another then condition. So click then add an action. Then click on issue actions and then click on refetch issue data and then click on next. And we're doing this because we're about to add the cycle time calculation and we want to be sure that the date CT end has actually been populated. Now we're going to add a final then condition. So click then add an action, then click issue actions and then click edit issue. In the choose fields to set box, select our custom field cycle time. Once you've selected that, you'll see a box labeled cycle time. In this box, type curly bracket, issue.ctstart.diff, open bracket, issue.ctend, close bracket, dot days, curly bracket, plus one. That is a mouthful. Now look, this takes the difference between our start and end dates and adds one day. Now click on more options and deselect notifications. Then click next and name your rule. If the name your rule box doesn't appear after clicking next, just click on turn on rule. I call mine cycle time end and allow all admins to edit. And very importantly, don't forget to click on turn on rule as the final step. This rule is now saved. Okay, that's it. We've created our three custom fields to hold our cycle time start and end date and to store our actual cycle time. We've created the two rules to populate them, plus add our cycle time in days to our custom field cycle time. Now all we need to do is let some time go by to allow our fields to get populated. Okay, so how do you extract this data? Well, firstly, let's have a look at what our custom fields and rules have created. So let's take a look at our sprint board. First, let's look at a story in the to-do column. You can see here that no cycle time dates or cycle time is displayed. And this is because our story hasn't triggered any automation yet, as it hasn't reached the in-progress status. The fields are empty until the automation rules are triggered. So let's take a look at a story in the in-progress column. Now here, you can see that our CT start, our cycle time start date, has been populated because it's triggered our first automation rule. So now let's take a look at a story in the done column. Now here we can see that the CT end, our cycle time end date, has been populated as well as our cycle time itself in days. Great, perfect. Now these fields are also non-editable, so no one can make any sneaky alterations. Okay, so now click on filters and then view all issues, and we can write a very basic JQL to get the data we need. So click the JQL button. In my example here, I'm just specifying my project where the issue type is set to story, has a status of done and was in sprint 4. And here are the results. So click export issues. But there is a nice way around this, which is a real time saver. You connect Excel to Jira. Now, it does require a plugin, and although it's free, it may not work for everyone for the same reasons that you can't install time and status or EazyBI in the first place. But for me, I just open Excel, click get Jira data, select filters, choose my filter and click on get data now. And here we go, very cool. This is just a small list from my test sprint 4. Yours will likely be much bigger depending on your Jira filter query. So now you can get your cycle time data for free natively within Jira, thank God. Once you have your cycle time data, it also gives you the only data you need to run Monte Carlo simulation, throughput. Now, this is your throughput here. It's your cycle time end date. The end date tells you that you've completed a story on this date. So all you would need to do is add up the number of stories completed on the same date and enumerate that in a date list, remembering to to put a zero in for any date where you didn't complete a story. Now, to find out how to run Monte Carlo Simulation with a free Excel template to allow you to do it, check the description. The video's on that below. Now, since this data is now available and visible in Jira, you could also build some nice dashboards to display cycle time data within Jira itself. So here's a very basic example of what it could look like. I could use this in your retro to analyze your throughput and cycle times to see if it needs attention, or have it on a dashboard for stakeholders so they can see progress. Now, you can do a lot with dashboards, and if you're interested in that, let me know what you'd like to see and I'll do a video on it. Now, to understand how to create your cycle times with percentiles, which is where the real power is, check this video out. Right, please don't forget to hit the like button, share and subscribe. Those things really help and I would greatly appreciate it. And if you're in a generous mood, click the thanks button below or the buy me a coffee link in the description. Okay, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Stay safe, stay humble, and I will see you next Thursday for another Agile Thought.